Hello, welcome to Podcast vs. Player. Today, another quiz, a brand new quiz. And as always, Dan is the man who's going to solve them all. Are you ready?
Don't sound too excited about it.
I'm very excited. I think this is a humdinger of a quiz.
Oh, cool.
And I've called it Celebritoony.
Okay, your weird pun name. I can't figure anything out from that. But
so,
sure.
So essentially, Dan, I'm going to present you with a celebrity that I have toonified via the power of AI. And you got to tell me what celebrity it is. You know 100% all of them.
Okay, cool. That's a good point. I was going to ask that.
There's no tricks. There's no celebrities you may or may not know. You know all of them.
Brilliant.
So, ready for your first one?
Bring it.
Let's go. It's a good start to just see the quality of what it's going to be like.
Wait a minute. So it's taking a cartoon picture and
No. It's taken a real person and made it into like a cartoony-esque face. So nobody has eyes and nose and stuff like that.
No, that's it just looks like a photograph that's just been warped slightly.
That's basically what all it is.
Right, okay. But it looks like the what's his face from Face Jacker and what phone jacker.
No.
And what we do in the shadows was named Novik something.
No, it's not him.
I can't remember.
Far more famous. These are all.
Keanu Reeves, isn't it? Wow, how did it? I mean, it's Disney-fied him.
That's basically
what
you're
doing. Flynn Rider's like badass older brother.
You're essentially looking at the Tangled generator.
Yeah. Why have you got the worst picture of Keanu Reeves ever?
I just got a high-res version of Keanu Reeves.
It looks like he's just been, you know, he's walking through a cold, wet New York evening and someone's just jumped in front of him and flashed a camera in his face.
I mean, it's definitely a press photo.
he's just fed up of John Wick and Matrix movies.
Yeah, he's just
please.
Had enough. He's tired, man.
I just want to do romantic comedies. Come on, please.
So you got one right, Dan. You got one right.
Okay, good. Okay.
Next one.
I'm looking at the hair for clues here.
Not as famous as Keanu Reeves.
No, but you're saying I know this person?
You 100% know this person. Not personally. You don't know any of these people personally. But
as far as you know.
You may keep some secrets from me. Very famous, but nowhere near the level of fame as Keanu Reeves.
Right, because I mean, I'm just like looking at the short hair. It's kind of got like an Anne Hathaway kind of vibe to it.
I'll point out as an extra clue, Dan.
Yeah.
Bear in mind it's AI, so it's everything's not taken exactly as it is from the photo.
Right.
The computer decides to do things in its own crazy way.
Oh, right, okay. Is this a female human?
It's definitely not female.
Oh, piss. Okay, well, that's really thrown me out of whack then.
It is human.
Okay.
It's probably more famous in Britain.
Matt Berry?
No.
Wow. Is it Jonathan Ross?
No. kind of on the same... The right line.
Oof, it's those eyebrows, they're throwing me off real bad.
I'll give you one last clue.
Okay.
You're focusing on the top too much.
Yeah, well, that chin doesn't give me anything.
It will, once you know who it is.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
I mean, all of it's irrelevant once you know who it is, but you know what I mean? Imagine like a really over-the-top representation of a person. So you're looking at the weird, quite odd-shaped face.
I don't know. There's something about this that seems really familiar, but I really can't place it.
I'm gonna give you one last clue.
All right. If you can give me one more that's not too obvious, go on.
Oh no, it's way obvious. You'll definitely get it.
Oh, okay. Jimmy Carr. Bloody hell. You're totally right. Totally right about the bottom half of the face being the key. That sort of roundy face that he's got.
I will say, though, this is my fault. The right one looks more like Jimmy Carr than the left one on that picture.
It just, you found the worst celebrity picture representations and then fed those into a machine and said, who's that then?
I'll be honest, I forgot about this till about half an hour before we were meant to record. So I literally just went high res, and then I was just putting like the name, so like high res Keanu Reeves, that one, that'll do. Feed it in, let's do it. So yeah, Jimmy Carr, your next one, sir.
Okay. Looks like a Muppet.
I mean, it could be. No, they're all human.
Oh, some big eyebrows, little mustache, little soul patch, a little bit of a soul patch going on, some weird glasses. Looks a bit Louis Theroux, doesn't it?
It's
like a caricature of Louis Theroux.
It's not.
No. You're going to have to start rolling those clues out for me, I think.
Incredibly famous. Probably on par. Probably more famous than Keanu Reeves.
Will Smith?
Will Smith?
I mean, kinda.
Absolutely not in any way, other than the fact that he's male. Famous than Will Smith as well.
More famous than Will Smith?
Especially over the last few years. Massively. Super hot, super, hot to the touch flavour.
Hot property.
Very hot property. Especially to us. Fucking hell. This is like what we've consumed.
Robert Downey Jr. Hello, there he is. Why does he look like his head's been turned into an orange?
I like to think that this is, if the guy from Up had a kid...
The guy from Up and the kid from Up, they had a
they
kid.
They had a kid, yeah.
That's what it would look like with a dog for eyebrows. Yeah, that whatever this machine is, it focuses on really obscure parts and then warps them a little bit.
It's very weird. Very weird.
That was a tricky one to get that.
Mr. Junior. Doesn't help that it's made him into glasses. It's made them into glasses and made him a bit like chubbier in the face.
Yeah, so kind of.
I know they are glasses, but like, if that to me, they look like sunglasses rather than real glasses. Do you know what I mean?
Sort of his, to be fair.
Nah, because they're only slightly tinted, aren't they?
Whereas
Robert Downey Jr.'s are like red.
Yeah.
But anyway, Robert Downey Jr. Boop. I will say this AI focuses a hell of a lot on eyebrows.
It really does, right? Yeah. Just pumps them right out. He's kind of got like the hair of Andrew Garfield, or sort of a Ryan Reynolds.
I'd go with the Garfield for the hair, definitely.
Yeah, right. It's sort of like a Hugh Jackman-y kind of.
That's what I should have done. I should have done like an amalgamation of celebrities into one face came out as.
Pick them apart. Those eyebrows, they're Hugh Jackman for sure, yeah. Maybe is this like the new casting list for, this is Wolverine for the next X-Men
film?
Could be.
Hello.
Maybe a bit Jerry Butler, maybe?
I can see it.
Do you know what I mean? Sort of like with the neck.
You're going to kick yourself if you don't get it.
I don't know, man. There's something about it. It's like with the shirt, maybe a bit Pierce Brosnan.
Like, it's definitely not Pierce Brosnan.
Thick, full hair. Good hair. Good set of hair on him.
I'm only going to give you one clue.
Okay, go on.
You've already said his name.
Oh, well, I'll tell you what. I'm not just going to sit there and just reel them off, right? But if I'm in the ballpark, just say, okay, yeah, sure, you get it. So, who was it? Right, okay, yeah, I totally got that then.
You get no points.
Oh. That's Mel Gibson. Like, here, I don't care what form you put his face in, I'll get him straight away every time. Look at that hair. Of course it is.
You say straight away every time. Let's just recap to the last T's and E's where you didn't get Mel Gibson.
Oh, no way, really?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, you strip all of his face out apart from his eyes and teeth. Yeah, that's definitely not going to work.
Next one, sir. You gotta get this.
John Travolta? Hello. That's what John Travolta used to look like.
This is like the one on the right. 13. Is the real photo.
Oh, really?
The one on the left looks like he has been and collected his face from Face Off.
No, I was just going to say, I reckon if Face Off was like a real thing and they actually did a face transplant, that's what it would look like.
Just like slight, because that doesn't look like a real picture of John Travolta.
No, it looks like the human Shrek.
I mean, that's Wayne Rooney, isn't it?
No, it's human Shrek from Shrek 2 with John Travolta's hair just popped on it. I'm telling you, it is, man.
This is the second also, one we've
why
had, though.
Why are his eyes brown?
Again, I don't make the AI.
So it changes the colour of the eyes as well.
Like I pointed out, it's not always a true representation of what the actual celebrity is. It's just gone what
I mean,
it's gone.
I mean, that's even close, mate. Yeah.
I mean, it is. You got it right, so it's got to be close.
I mean, it's like 20% similarity, mate.
And I would still argue that the one on the right looks more like John Travolta than the one on the left.
Nah. I'd say that the one on the right, that's more Jimmy Carr than Carr one was, I'd say.
Boop.
That's a lady.
It definitely is. A lady you are very fond of.
Well, that narrows it down to two, maybe? So I'm going to say it's Mary Elizabeth Winston. Ding, ding! Again, now, like, the fringe. Where's it gone?
Would you have got that without my clue?
No, because it looks like a Bratz doll. That's why.
Ironically, the one on the left was a photo from the Bratz movie.
No, I reckon if you went on Wish and bought the Mary Elizabeth Winstanley sex doll, the one on the right is what would turn up.
That looks like the one that we made the dating profile for.
Oh, yeah.
Lucifer. Anyway. Dink.
It's like looking through a crystal ball, like, you know, when they're just sort of like, oh, I'm seeing like images of the future, like just bits of.
I'd say it's more like looking into a spoon.
Ah, there's something, like, those eyes are really big. Pulled those eyes out, hasn't it?
I'll be honest, it hasn't. This is real close. This is probably the closest one.
Angelina Jolie.
No, not even close, mate.
Oh, really?
No.
I thought that, like, she's got like big eyes, hasn't she?
This is probably the only one that looks very, very similar to the actual real life celebrity.
I'm looking at the hair for clues. Like an Ellen DeGeneres kind of deal.
Way more famous than Ellen. Way more famous. I'm talking Hollywood elite.
Hollywood elite.
And been in films like both really like and dislike.
The nose, this AI thing, like the nose, it seems to keep fairly close to the actual picture. Mm. So I'm trying to look at nose and eyes.
Realistically, eyes, nose, mouth, very similar.
Shoulders, knees and toes, yeah.
Knees and toes. The eyes, only thing nose, I'd probably say in this makes her look a lot younger.
See, I know that you won't get this reference at all, but Lucille 2 from Arrested Development.
Like Arrested Development. And I'm not having this argument again.
Right, Lucille 2. Like Lucille 2, 30 years before.
I mean, I see where you're going, but you're focusing on the wrong parts of it.
Dang it. It's very Hollywood elite. Like a Scarlett Johansson, maybe?
No.
Dang it. I'm stumped. Absolutely stumped. I can't get Lucille 2 out of my head now.
All right, I'll give you two clues.
What?
The kind of thing. So, was in a movie franchise. Was in a franchise, but the only one she was in, most people despise, a comic book franchise. Yet, one of the films that you love is very, very, very well liked all across the world. So two very different spectrums of like ratings and credibility. She's been in a film with someone else who's been on this list. I'm trying to be very vague as to not just give you the answer.
I'm absolutely... I have no idea.
I'll give you a clue for the film that you hate, but it's not her. Okay. It's not a line that she says.
Right.
But it probably will give it away.
Okay.
The Ice Age cometh.
Uma Thurman. Wow. Oh, but... Why is that the worst picture of Uma Thurman I've ever seen?
Again.
Oh, bless her.
High res. That's all I went with.
You could have got like a nice snapshot from Kill Bill or Pulp Fiction or something like that.
Well, no, I don't want to give it away. I've tried to go with all similar backgrounds. And I don't mean like where they grew up. I mean like plain backgrounds.
it's like the Uma Thurman Barbie doll, isn't it?
But do you see what I mean, though? That looks a lot like Uma Thurman.
Now that you say it, kind of.
But
it's like if Uma Thurman robbed you, and then you had to speak to like the police, shot,
like a sketch artist.
Yeah. And he's like, "Is this her?" And then you put those wanted posters up.
No, but I've gone with because the original one for this one I used was Poison Ivy, but the background fucked up with the like where it was generating, so it was adding parts to the background, so she had like a hand, not a hand coming out of her head, but like it was just really, everything was off, so I've tried to go with very plain simple background.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
But yeah, not the best picture, but Uma Thurman.
Okay.
Boop. Again, franchise very close to your heart, Dan. It's not the Addams Family.
It kind of looks like Amy Winehouse a little bit.
It's not Amy Winehouse. It's not. They're all, for the most part, they're all movie stars. There's a couple that aren't.
Right. Okay. So short hair.
What I'd probably do for this one is look
Carrie
at
Carrie Moss.
Just look at the exact person that it is.
Wow, that was an absolute shot in the dark. I can't believe that paid off.
What I was going to say was like look at action figures and stuff, but yeah,
get it straight off. If you went to some dodgy toy store, when you went into like the Home Bargains or whatever, this is Tronity. That's like
Tronity
at the back of the dolls section. Yeah, I think it was the short hair again. I think the hair's. I'm focusing in on it, but it seems to be paying off.
That to me, that looks like somebody else, and I can't think who it is. But
oh, brilliant.
this is what it would be if you went into. So you know when we've done Dumpster Jive?
Yeah.
This is like some knockoff back alley toy shop who has got a Bratz doll and just put it in a leather jacket and gone, Trini, and that's all it is. It's just like a proper knockoff figure. But the real person, I can't think who it is. But it definitely doesn't look. I don't know how the fucking hell you got Carrie-Anne Moss from that. I genuinely don't.
Short black hair.
That could be any. That could be me.
But that's. It's the way my brain's working. But I'm on a roll here. Come on.
You are. Boop. This one's quite close, actually. Ignore the glitchy.
That looks like a Snapchat filter.
Ignore the glitchy stuff at the bottom. Focus on the face.
Face.
This ain't far off, I will say. Once you get who it is.
Elizabeth Olsen.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god. The hair again. I was like, oh, it's nice sort of like red hair.
That's probably the closest one.
Yeah, I'd say so. That's real close to the actual thing, yeah.
Not bad. Boop.
He's
bit surprised,
like...
whoever it is.
Rhett MacLachlan from Good Mythical Morning.
Without the glasses.
He does make... No, Lindquist. Lindquist glasses.
Oh, no, Lindquist. Yeah, sorry. Another big star.
It's tasty little beard he's got there. Chris Evans. Mate, crushing it.
Where did my eyebrows come from?
I have no idea. Clearly, the AI knew what you were doing and it's trying to throw me some curveballs.
It is. I snuck
look at the repeat that's on his chin.
Yeah.
Beard on his chin.
Couldn't quite pick up all them. I think it's because there's bits of dark brown, light brown, grey. And it's just going, oh, fuck.
It's like an old printer that you just pulled it out too quickly, yeah.
That's exactly what it looks like. Well done, yeah, Chris Evans.
Okay.
Not as famous, but you know who it is.
Glasses. It's like a Chris Evans kind of look, isn't it? Like if you took like... Are you kidding me? I was joking! I was going to say like, oh God, remember TGI Fridays? Or TFI Fridays, sorry.
But again,
like, if you animated that show, that's what he'd look like.
But he's giving him eyebrows that he hasn't even got.
Yeah, it plays heavily into the eyebrows, yeah. Doesn't it? Bloody hell.
I can't believe you got that one.
What a guess, holy shit.
That's like a better looking Chris Evans.
Yeah, that's not bad. It's a very curly hair there.
It's not Amy Winehouse.
Are we talking movie stars again?
Been in movies. Been in TV. Probably better known for TV.
Looks a bit like Cher, doesn't it?
Zoe said Cher.
Sort of like, you know, the wavy, beautiful.
Not as famous as Cher.
Well, who is, mate?
Chris Evans, apparently. You got both of them in a fucking row.
Yeah, can't get this lady, though. God damn. We're still talking recent movies, or?
Yeah, last few years. Got one coming up. Got a new season of a show coming up. Very popular TV show.
Very popular.
Huge, some may even say. Some may even say it started most of the cast of this show's career.
Is that like a How I Met Your Mother sort of thing?
No, fucking way bigger. Like, oh my God, no, you disgust me.
I was going to say, because I don't know anyone from that other than whoever it was that played Willow in Buffy.
Would you think I would put somebody from the Big Bang Theory in this, Dan?
But this is it. I wasn't sure if you were throwing me a curveball.
It's all people you know from films you've watched and TV shows you've watched.
Is it Sigourney Weaver?
I gave you a massive clue. It's not a girl.
You're joking?
No.
Really?
I was going to drag this one out as long as possible, but...
Bloody hell.
I feel you're guessing. You're going to just guess completely wrong because you're going to just assume it's a girl.
Well, yeah, kind of. I mean, how does it... Doesn't it look like Sigourney Weaver? Like original aliens, like...
I can see, yeah. A bit too much hair, but I can see it.
Dang, that's a dude.
Yeah. This one's real good.
That hair, is that Hasselhoff?
It's not David Hasselhoff. Do you think I could put a picture of David Hasselhoff through this and it would come out looking like a woman?
Bloody hell, who the bloody hell else could it be? I'll need a clue on this. I have absolutely no idea.
The film that's coming up is like a more of a soft reboot of a super, super popular franchise. And the
Dune.
No. And the way bigger than that. We're looking forward to it. And the TV show is on Netflix. Probably, last clue, probably the biggest show to come from Netflix.
The biggest show on, like, Stranger Things? That's kind of one of the biggest that Netflix has ever made.
I'd say so.
So this is someone from Stranger Things?
I'd say so. If you tell me you can't mention, say any of the names, I'll just give you the point. Tell you what, I'll give you half a point because you got Stranger Things.
Okay, well, it's one of the... Oh, Finn Wolfhard. Oh my, yeah. I didn't realise that, like, you of course, someone quite young, it wouldn't be able to determine, you know, there's no, like, real strong, like, facial traits either way,
yeah,
is there?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's just sort of gone, a girl, I guess?
For once, though, got the eyebrows not far off.
pretty close, but, yeah, not great.
Give up.
I honestly, mate, if you hadn't given me that clue, never in a million years, I don't think I would have got that.
Honestly, as soon as it came...
With the you know, the Ben Stiller, like, Starsky and Hutch hair.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, just huge curls. God damn.
As soon as that came out, I went, you ain't never getting that one. Put it in.
Absolutely not. Wow.
Because originally I was going to do 11, but as 11, but
with no hair.
Yeah,
see,
yeah,
it
yeah.
Did with that.
But it didn't come out great, so...
No.
But I couldn't
That's
get
a good
I couldn't
one,
get
mate.
A good enough
yeah,
picture.
I... Definitely couldn't have got that one without the ever helpful clues.
Right, next one, sir.
Bring. Go on. That's Zach from Arnie Donner. Of course it is.
We've always got to get one in.
Oh yeah, baby. It was Mark last time. Now it's Zach. Hello.
There was a better one, but the mouth was really bad. So he kind of looked like he had like a W mouth. That's how it came out, and I was like, ugh. That looks really horrible. So
I'll give you a point. For you, a special point if you can tell me what Zach's surname is.
Oh, fucking hell. Oh, my goodness. I do know as well, because I had to fucking download the picture.
Googling.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I can never remember his bloody surname.
Oh, fucking hell. That's really annoying.
It doesn't matter. On to the next one.
No, it's really annoying because I had it earlier. Yeah. I know it begins with an R.
I'm going to Google it then, and
if it begins with an R, it's like
if it does, I'll give it you.
It's like Rona or Ruan, Ronan, something like that.
Ruane. I'll give you that.
Did you
Proper
see
Australian
when you Googled it? Did you see the first picture that comes up? He's got a man.
Oh,
bun.
I just.
Oh.
No. Oh, a man bun.
Yeah, but it doesn't look like him at all.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I cut all this bit out.
I was going to say, we're not talking about Arnie Donner in this. Not for longer than we need to, anyway.
But yeah, we're looking...
That's like a Zach Arnie Donner Snapchat filter, isn't it? You just put that over your own face.
Mate, it's got like the hair and the eyes and everything.
And the beard, yeah.
Right, your next
one. Hold on, I'm going to sneeze. Oh, there we go.
Did you sneeze?
Yeah.
All right. I didn't hear anything.
Oh, hold on. Oh, sorry. I had to do it again. Okay, I'm good.
Right, ready?
Zach.
Right, next one, sir.
Is that Raoul?
Zoe said exactly the same thing.
Looks like Raoul Coley,
it's
doesn't it?
Definitely not. But now it makes me think I wish I had put Raoul in it.
I'm trying to steer away from the eyebrows because they seem to be very misleading, those eyebrows.
I'd say for this one, you'd want to be looking at your eyebrows and your beard.
Mason? Nick Mason? Hey! That's two in a row that people are never going to get.
Ironically,
Nick Mason.
Ironic as well, saying is... Nick Mason's very rarely in a video, like face-wise.
Mm-hmm.
So, I thought I'd go with the best picture I could possibly find off his Instagram.
Brilliant. Absolutely perfect, yeah.
Next
it's
one.
It's a Mr. Sunday Movies plug for you.
Because they need it. Fucking hell.
Yeah, yeah.
Big.
Tom Cruise, Last Samurai.
Absolutely not. You...
Really?
1,000% should get this, but I don't think that you will.
It's not Tom Cruise.
It's definitely not Tom Cruise. Not as famous as Tom Cruise.
He's got some very Tom Cruise-y hair going on.
Maybe to you. But to everybody else, he's just a number.
Jonathan Frakes.
Hey!
I'll be honest, that was an incredible clue. Yeah. I did. It registered just before you said it. And I wish I hadn't now, because I wish that clue had given it to me, but... That looks like, it's like Riker when he was 13.
That looks like, more that like Flynn Rider.
It does, right? Yeah. But he's kind of got like the Tom Cruise like flowing like Top Gun locks.
It's weird because like, I mean, Jonathan Frakes is a good looking chap anyway.
Oh, he is, yeah.
This has made him like a Disney prince good looking.
I mean, his eyeballs are a bit weird.
Not with the eyes. I mean, he's definitely like Buzz Eye to fuck. But I don't think it helps that obviously he's kind of like raising his eyebrow on that picture, so his eyes a little bit closed.
So it's moved his entire eyes up and down a bit. Yeah, a little bit.
But I didn't think you'd get that. I'll be honest, I did not think you'd get it.
I clocked it just before the number one clue. But if I hadn't at that point, that would have 100% given it away. Good clue.
Bink.
Patrick Stewart. Yeah.
With hair.
I mean, I like the fact that it's making up hair and eyebrows and sideburns for him. But
and that's it, mate. That's your last one. That was it.
Oh, dang. We fucking rinsed it.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, what an outstanding effort. Well done.
Editor, put in the score. And then we'll record two again. Oh, better luck next time, Dan. Congratulations. You got so many right.
I think I got maybe 8 or 9, I'd say, of those.
You got more than I expected you to. I will say that.
Well, I think you were quite generous with the clues, but I like the generous clue giving because it makes me feel that you want me to succeed in my life.
I like to
where
think
usually
that.
Usually, you're trying to bring me down into the fucking dirt with the rest of you.
See the Unravel 2 video. But I like to think, even though, you know, I'm doing the quiz, that we're a team. If you win, I win.
Ish. I feel like I won.
I'd say you got more than two, so that's a definite victory in my eyes.
I got Chris Evans and Elizabeth Olsen. I'll take that alone. That'll do for me.
I mean, you got I'm not going to work them out, but you got a good amount right. But no, that's it. If you want to check some more stuff out, go to the website, www.podcastversusplayer.com or youtube.com/podcastversusplayer. Dan, thanks for playing.
Thank you, Callum.
You're always welcome. And yeah, we'll see you on the next one. Bye!
Bye.
Can we pipe bomb it? Git.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Callum.
I was trying to pipe bomb it.
Just shoot it. Just shoot. Mate, why don't you start fucking doing your job properly, Vice President Material, my tits. Like, you're going to have to shoot that because I haven't got enough bullets to do it.
Oh, I'm out.
What do you mean?
Helicopter killed me.
For the love of fucking Christ, Callum. If I was going to just do this thing on my own, I wouldn't have bothered asking your stupid ass to get involved, would I? Right,
see?
Get in the car. Not in the back.
I don't want to sit in the front with you.
Right, I've got 14 bullets left for this.
Why don't we just use the pipe bombs?
Big bomb, Callum. I'm going to fucking hide you in a minute. Why don't we just use the pipe bombs? I'll tell you what. Fucking have at it. If you think you can blow one of these things off using a pipe bomb, feel bloody free.
Okay.
Brilliant.
It worked.
So you
fucking
did.
But it worked. It took the brake off, Dan. Did it not?